Hello, it's Jang here with some more LEGO Minifigures Online, kind of bonus footage as I continue through the pirate world. There's a lot more to this single initial opening world than I expected. I'm trying to get into the Volcano Island section of it, which should lead up to the final battle and all. And this is the jump off. Here we go. Now we're into a different space. See, this is what I was looking for. I was looking for getting into an area that was different looking. Doesn't look like, I mean, it's still pirate world, so it's still gonna have a lot of the same basic characters. They've just been modified a little bit, looks like. Fire hound rather than tigers, and some fire monkeys around the place as well. But this is pretty cool looking, at least. I really like the background, what I'm seeing out there. There's another man cannon. Yeah, look at the depth. It's pretty cool just how much space is actually included back there and rendered in 3D. Always appreciate that. Okay, what is going on here? Lots of explosions. Lots and lots of explosions. At least they're all coming up in the same place. This is an FPS reducer section right here. It'll be interesting to see how this works on some of the lower powered devices you can play the game on, because that's a lot of animations going on at once. Lots and lots of fire monkeys. All right, get rid of them. All of them. Bye-bye. This revolutionary soldier is just too powerful. All right, what is this? That is quite a jump. Looks like that, it's gonna be a major area back there, I am sure. This is it. This could be it. This could be the final battle. Come on, come on, Clicky. Pocket adventure. At least I get the hot dog man out of it. That'll be interesting to see how that one plays. But yeah, just a pocket adventure. Defeat the champion. All right, I will. More monkeys. Whoa. Once again, they tried to ambush me. Some monkeys. Those things blow up. The fire hounds, they blow up and it has an area effect. It's not too strong though. Oh, look at the cute little dragon! The tiny little thing. But it's burning me. Gosh! It took away like 3/4 of my health right there. Ouch. At least it doesn't have too much defense. Bad dragon. Bad baby dragon. Finish you off with some pizza. There we go. And I get the hot dog man. All right. A lot of folks are a big fan of this actual real minifig. Let's see what I get here. Sea Captain Head and a bunch more. Did you just see those skeletons coming? Oh, here's some more loot. Open that up. Just stars. The skeletons were coming from way, way back. I passed those, like, I don't know, 3 minutes ago, something like that. Look at this. They've been following me this whole time. I'm gonna get you. Hate these shields, they last too long. Just can't do any damage to them while the shield is up. Then once the shield is down, then they just crumble. All right, check out this hot dog guy. Where's he at? Hot dog man. Yes. Clicky, not too bad, pretty well balanced. I mean, he's a builder, so he's mostly on the creative side, but he has decent power and defense. I'll go ahead and equip him up in place of the Roman commander. Let's see what we've got for upgrades. Yeah, instant upgrade. This is, okay, build him, build faster. Good, this will be my new main builder. Upgrade some more. And I can't get to the last one because I'm not level 9 just yet. Level 8, got a little ways to go. That's the, This guy is silly, that's good. You need it to be. So that was that. This thing is pointing me, looking at the arrow in the mini-map. This is not where I came from. I see, so that was the pocket adventure there, and I didn't really need to do that. I could have just gone directly to the man cannon, and that would have taken me along my way, so I kind of did a little extra excursion there. But that's good, because I got the hot dog man now. speed boost. It's really funny that he's hopping along. That's funny how they make it so that he kind of can't move his legs very much. He didn't seem to build all that fast for all the building speed updates. His attacks are okay, and he's not a striker character. Let me try his secondary. The hot dog roll secondary attack. Just kind of rolls himself up into a blanket and just goes through all of them. Not too bad of an attacker, but probably won't last very long as a primary one. Line more of these things up. Get that secondary. That the roll goes pretty far. Looks like it does most of its damage when the enemies land. Not when you first hit them, but when they land back down on the ground. Here we go. Another intermediate mini-boss type of thing. What are these orbs? Look like something that's too powerful for him to have. Lots and lots of bad guys. This is a little constrained little space. Roll right through them. My health. That was not good. Okay, well, this is actually becoming more challenging still. Don't want to get hit by those orbs, that's for sure, whatever they are. I should actually probably take a hit from one just to see how much damage it does, but it doesn't look like it'll be good. Level 9 means that I can upgrade again. That's good. Oh, there we go. Just got hit by one and it didn't do much. Maybe it has an aura effect. I'm not sure. But this was a good little encounter. Hey, there are still things out there. Scarecrow, Shadow Defender. Probably won't use that one. Still getting beat up out here. Come on. I think those are his minions. There we go. And the last of them. All right, more loot. Always a good thing. Sea Captain Legs, another health potion. Let's see what else I got. Hot Dog Smash is what they call that. Main attack doesn't really do all that much. See, these parts, I've been collecting these parts, and I have not built anything from them. Have all the parts to make this one. Go ahead and put it together. You don't have to spend any stars. You know, you just get the parts, and then you just push a button, and they get assembled. So this is another builder character, and then the Sea Captain. Build him. It's basically free, you know, just from picking up parts along the way. Nature Defender, another one that I probably won't use. But I had extra pieces from each of those, and those, I think, just get thrown into this kind of grab bag, just a general thing. You can convert them into stars, not into other parts. Okay, I'll just kind of keep that for now. I'm not really needing stars that much. Got one of those little things you can dig up down here. Another trophy for whatever that's for. A nose for gold. Sniff out all buried treasure in the pirate world. So it's called buried treasure. I have not seen anything about that. I didn't know what it was for. Now I know. Buried treasure. I get a little award for it. Don't think it gave me anything I can actually use, but it's a little thing for completionists. Story dungeon, okay. This is gonna move on towards the major serious stuff. Now this should take me towards the end of the pirate world, I think. All right.
Shave me, Beard. How'd you make it past the volcano, the skeletons, and the hounds?
I walked.
The crystal compass be giving you powers. You have what it takes to bring me down. You're gonna have to defeat me best, the most vicious ghost crew first.
Will do. Find and face Captain Dreadleg once again. Area quest. Defeat Skimpy Bob. Alright. Another little mini boss. He does not have very good defense, and it looks like he doesn't have great offense either. So this is a relatively easy one, at least for my revolutionary soldier, who is the bomb. Yeah, there you go. One skeleton just running away. I've never seen that before. Sad clown head. And some more stars and stuff. Alright, time to finish this guy off once and for all. Got another lieutenant. Bites the dust. Hey, and he gives me loot. Oh, awesome. Sad clown legs. I killed your brother. Now I kill you. And another loot chest. Awesome. Couple of healing potions there. Let's see what I got going on for level 9. Take less damage after using my special attack. I will take it. Most definitely. What else I got? Pizza guy. Move faster. That's good. I definitely like being able to move around. If I want to skip through areas, then I want to do it as quickly as possible. So this guy will become my runner while the hot dog man is my builder. Extra toppings. I'll take them. 800 stars? Okay deal. Smash an enemy. You heal a small amount. So that's kind of like lifesteal. That can be a very good thing. Too bad he's not a striker, though.
Shiver me timbers and sink me ship. Again. You landlubbers don't know when to give up, aye? Gonna have to deal with you myself. Gonna have to put you in your place, aye?
Your power comes from a curse, Dreadleg. Give it up. Stop this craziness.
You call me powers a curse, but they make me invincible. I'll take your crystal compass and plunder all the Lego worlds, aye? Got a bit dizzy there. Anyways, come and face me steel and me cannons. I'll show you all how I'm the only true captain.
So I'm a little confused. First up, he, you know, right at the beginning of the game, he steals the crystal compass that I had and didn't realize. And now, you know, then we very quickly defeat him the first time and we take the crystal compass back. And he's like, it's no big deal. And now he's super determined to get the crystal compass because with it, he's going to dominate the entire universe. So he needs to make up his mind. Is it important to him or is it not? Is it the key to everything or is it not? This time he came with over 20,000 hit points. See how he comes back next time. I like that ghost ship. It's not working. My primary attack was not working. I was getting some lag right there. Again! I'm clicking, and it's not good. Secondary attack works just fine. That's good for the group. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with this. No. Secondary attack works just fine. Primary is not. All right, let's see what we get out of this guy. Taking a while to get his hit points down. I have a feeling that he's gonna reach a second version, or either that or his minions will start coming in bigger groups or with stronger ones. See what happens when I get him past the halfway point. That's usually the trigger, is the halfway point on the hit points of bosses in games. Get pretty close. Come on. Looks like that defense effect that I got from the level 9 upgrade starts working immediately and lasts for about 3 seconds. And it lasts if you switch characters. That was interesting. Something I'll have to look into in the future. Obviously, you know, the level of difficulty for battles is increasing. I think for the next section, you know, I wanted to just get through the main mechanics of the game through this first world, but as I move on to the next world, I think I'll start to really think about putting together my team, you know, optimizing a little more for battle, and depending upon, you know, what type of area I'm going into. Because one thing that I haven't talked about at all is the elemental effect system. On a lot of the smaller, like the pocket adventures and things, they'll actually, whoa, almost died, not good. They'll actually show you little hints on the screen of what elements will work better in that area. And if you switch to a character that has that element on them, like the Hot Dog Man is a light builder, he uses the element of light, then if you're in an area where light is most effective, you'll do more damage. Now, I've seen that effect But, you know, at the lower levels, it doesn't... Oh, yeah, not good. At the lower levels, it doesn't matter that much, ultimately. But now, oh, gosh, no. He has not healed. That was my first time, I think, in this game, ever using a health potion. To get a little more serious. Yeah, definitely starting with the next world. I'm going to probably put a lot more focus on striker teams and try to synergize some of the secondary attacks also. Gosh, that whirlwind is actually pretty serious. The little mini bosses and things before who have had whirlwinds did almost no damage, but this guy, this time... Oh, no. Go, 32! I wonder what happens when you die in this game. That's something I have not done. I should try that at some point just to see, or at least look up what it does. I'm assuming it's not permanent though. Yeah, his little guys now have are all doing ranged attack, and they have a close range attack, you know, a direct attack as well. Dreadleg is really low, but still hanging in there, and I am still in kind of in trouble. My second health potion. I want to make sure I finish this off strong. Nope. Still don't want that. Here we go. Yeah. Come on. No. Don't die. There. Do die.
Stand down, Dreadleg. You're beaten. What do you have to say for yourself?
All me wanted was respect. Captain Pete marooned me, and then I found this cave. Before me knew it, me was cursed. The islander shaman told me that the only way to break the curse was the crystal compass.
Oh, you didn't need to steal it. You could have just asked to borrow it.
Pirating and plundering be the only things me know. Me just wants to go back to being smith.
You've touched me, Dreadleg. We can try.
What?
Ye did it!
What?
The curse is broken, and I feel so alive.
How come it didn't work the first time when he stole it and when he was right there in front of him in the beginning of the game? How come it didn't work?
Ha ha! You did it! Dreadleg is no more, and Smith is back! I knew you had it, matey. I knew it all along. And look at all this treasure. Every good adventure ends with a bit of treasure.
There might even be enough here to pay back all your debts, Swashbuckler.
Drat! The spell failed again. I said bearer of the crystal compass, not den of smelly pirates.
Hey, what are you calling smelly, mate? I smell like roses. Now, did you say crystal compass?
Do you know where it is, young man? The kingdom is in trouble, and the crystal compass might be our only hope.
Maybe we know, and maybe we don't. I'll pass along your message.
Youth these days. No respect for their elders.
No respect.
It sounds like medieval world is in trouble. On the other hand, we could also go and plunder Treasure Island. Well, to get to either of them, we need to go through Lego Center.
So, I hope this doesn't take me away. I want to get those stars. Ah! So the ex-Dreadleg, Captain Smith, is now playable. And he is a striker as well. Need to check that out. Here's my plunder. Is there anything else? Try this guy out too. All power, almost no defense, almost no building skill. Give him a little extra health since his defense is so low. Oh, that's right, I got level 9 too. Okay, help with the recharge. Use your normal attack to speed up the recharge of your secondary attack. Look at that, he actually gets 2 bombs. You can actually use them at the same time. All right. Travel to Lego Center. This will be to the main hub. Oh.
Aha! Thought you were going to have a rest, did you? Heroes don't get to have breaks. Don't blame me. I didn't write the hero handbook. Besides, the wizard sounded worried, and there's nothing worse than a worried wizard, except a warty witch. Yes, all right, to medieval world. Just follow that suspicious-looking jester.
Sweet! That was the end of Pirate World. I think I've got a little more... I think there were some pocket adventures and things that I didn't go into, but I'll take care of that offline just for a little XP. That does it for this video, though. In the next video, things will get more interesting. Like I said, I will actually put some effort into setting up my teams a little bit more efficiently, and I'll kind of just bump up the whole enthusiasm in general of the fighting and all, and try to start, you know, really smashing through some stuff relatively quickly as I explore the medieval world. So that's to come. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you've continued to be able to enjoy this series with me, and I'll be talking to you again very soon.